Tank Corps Memorial in Poissiers in France. And this is like the Graceland for all tank fans. Why? Because this is the first place where tanks saw actual action ever. This place on the Somme battlefield was selected as the place for the memorial because it was near the location that tanks first went into action with the British Army as a new surprise super weapon against the German Army in the First World War. This monument consists of two bronze plaques and four bronze tank models, and one of these models is hit by a 50 cal after a strafing run in World War II when this position was held by German forces. A point of interest is that the fence around the memorial was built out of 6-pounder guns from actual tanks found on the battlefield and driving chains. And you can still see the battle damage on them. I don't know if it's from the strafing run or from actual tank battles, but yeah. But if you're close to this place, really see the memorial. It's really worth your time. Across from the British Tank Corps Memorial is the Australian Memorial and Poissiers Windmill. And this place is particularly important because it was fought over fiercely, and historians believe it took more Australian lives in this battle than any battle ever fought. And I'm sorry for the wind, but yeah, what can you do? It's a hillside, and possibly the reason that there was a windmill here. And this windmill was a landmark, and it was gradually destroyed over time by British and French artillery. At some point the German army built a bunker next to it, but that also was gradually destroyed over time by all the artillery shells. You can still see some debris of the windmill and some foundation of the blockhouse or bunker, but that's about it. There's not much left here. So if you want to see this place in peace and quiet and in its original state, you need to hurry up, because they want to build it into another tourist trap. And with this tourist trap, there comes screaming babies, annoying parents, and those idiotic school children.